Holy Church. This morning we are celebrating the solemnity of the Most Holy Trinity.
As we begin our celebration, we pause in silent prayer, asking the Lord's mercy and forgiveness.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
God our Father, who by sending into the world the word of truth and the spirit of sanctification, make known to the human race to the wondrous mystery, grant us, we pray, that in professing the true faith, we may acknowledge the Trinity of eternal glory and adore your unity, powerful in majesty. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, ask now of the days of old, before your time, ever since God created man upon the earth. Ask from one end of the sky to the other, did anything so great ever happen before? Was it ever heard of? Did a people ever hear the voice of God speaking from the midst of fire as you did and lived? Or did any God venture to go and take a nation for himself from the midst of another nation by testings, by signs and wonders, by war, with strong hand and outstretched arm, and by great terrors, all of which the Lord your God did for you in Egypt before your very eyes? This is why you must now know and fix in your heart that the Lord is God, in the heavens above and on the earth below, and that there is no other. You must keep his statutes and commandments that I enjoin on you today, that you and your children after you may prosper, and that you may live long life on the land which the Lord your God is giving you forever. The word of the Lord.
Listen, O people of the Lord, as Joseph. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, those who are led by the Spirit of God are sons of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you received a spirit of adoption through whom we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit himself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God, and if children, then heirs, heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ. If only we suffer with him, so that we may also be glorified with him. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
With
you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. The 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had ordered them. When they all saw him, they worshipped, but they doubted. Then Jesus approached and said to them, "All power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always, until the end of the age." The Gospel of the Lord.
Dear friends, there are so many mysteries in the world, so many things that we don't understand. When you go to a doctor's office, for example, with a sprained ankle or wrist, and you see the diagrams on the wall, you see how intricate and complex we are. Or the universe, for example. We live in a galaxy comprised of millions of stars. And then there are millions of galaxies in an ever-expanding universe. There is the mystery of life itself, of life growing in the womb, the miracle of new life. So we are filled with awe and wonder. And it's not surprising then that when we reflect on the inner life of God, we come face to face with the greatest mystery of all, that God reveals himself to us as a trinity of persons, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Three persons equal and distinct, and yet one God. Over the centuries, people have tried to understand the Trinity, to see what its meaning is in their lives. We're told that St. Patrick used the three-leaf shamrock to explain the mystery, and many other images have been used as well. But God is mystery. The words we use about God are always inadequate, so we speak of three persons in one God. It tells us one thing, that God doesn't live in solitary splendor. God is a community of persons. God is an intimate circle of total love and understanding, a love that brimmed over into this world by bringing it into existence. Furthermore, it is a love that has brought Jesus into the world as one of us and made it possible for us to be brought into intimate friendship with God. When we think of our day-to-day living, we can see there are times when we connect with each of the three persons of the Trinity. We see God as Father, as Creator, the one who creates this beautiful world. The changing seasons, the sunset and the fall, rainbow as you drive home from work, crash of the waves on the beach. And inside you, you have a sense of awe and wonder. The time you held your baby in your arms for the first time and realized that we are indeed made in the image and likeness of God. As the psalmist tells us, we are fearfully, wonderfully made. We begin to realize that we are formed for a reason and a purpose that brings meaning to each day. There are times, too, when we are close to Christ, the second person of the Trinity, and we can easily relate to him. We're inspired by his life and teachings as they come to us from the Gospels. We see how his words give direction to our lives. Love one another as I have loved you. Forgive not 7 times, but 70 times 7 times. As long as you did it to one of these, you did it to me, and so on. We can identify with him because he has shared his life with us. He knows our joys and our struggles, and he wants to be closely united with us. Especially here, as we celebrate the Eucharist, he shares his very life with us, nourishing us with his body and blood. He is the one who rose from the dead, and so that we might have eternal life. And finally, we can also connect with the Holy Spirit, the third person of the Blessed Trinity, who never leaves us abandoned or neglected. The Spirit moves in and among us, enlightening us, aiding our intellect, and helping us to fathom the mysteries surrounding us. The Spirit who always reminds us of Christ and his words. The Spirit who leads us into all truth. How can we make the Trinity come alive more in our lives? One way that some people find helpful is a prayer exercise they follow each night before falling asleep. You might find it helpful too. They take 3 minutes to replay the day that has just ended. During the first minute, you pick the high point of the day, spending time with your family and friends, salary raise, an opportunity to reach out to someone in need, a conflict resolved, and you then speak to the Father about it and give thanks. During the second minute, you think of the low point of the day, something that you're sorry for, like ignoring someone who needed your help, or you were impatient with someone and said things that you regretted. You can speak to Jesus about it and ask his forgiveness. And during the third minute, you look ahead to tomorrow and the things that have to be done. You speak to the Holy Spirit about it and ask for the wisdom and courage you need to deal with them properly. As you can see, this simple exercise combines prayer with an examination of conscience. But more importantly, it brings the Holy Trinity into the nitty-gritty of our days. So as we profess our faith today in the Trinity of persons and the one God, may we also pray to them to help us become the kind of person we are meant to be, a true child of the Father, the living image of Christ his Son, and a consecrated temple of the Holy Spirit.
Now profess the great truth of our faith. I believe in one God, Father the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, died from God, light from light, true God from true God. Begotten, not made, consubstantial of the Father, through him all things are. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified and Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will not know it. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Prompted and inspired by Holy Spirit, let us offer our petitions to the Father.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. We thank God for the gift of baptism, and we pray that we may be worthy of our calling. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us thank God for all our gifts. As these gifts are freely given to us, may we freely share them with others. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us thank God for those who have shown us kindness in times of trouble. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
On this Memorial Day weekend, we remember those in the armed forces who have given their lives so that we might enjoy the gift of freedom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and those who have asked us to pray for them, especially Michael Vickers, Elaine Krizak, Philip Shearman, and Robert McGurran. May they soon enjoy the gift of health. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, especially Mary Day, Thomas Mayer, John Cosgren, Kathleen Mahoney, Francois Roy Turgan, and Alice Roy. May they find a place in God's heavenly home.
Lord,
let us now include our personal needs and intentions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for revealing yourself to us as a Trinity of persons. We thank you also for the many blessings you give us each day and for listening to all the needs that we bring before you, which we make. My friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice of your hands for his glory and all good.
Grant to your church, O Lord, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace, whose signs are to be seen in mystery in the offerings we here present through Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, be with you.
Lift
up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For at the Last Supper with his apostles, establishing for the ages to come the saving memorial of the cross, he offered himself to you as the unblemished Lamb, the acceptable gift of perfect praise. Nourishing your faithful in this sacred mystery, you make them holy so that the human race, bounded by one world, may be enlightened by one faith and united by the one bond of charity. And so we approach the table of this wondrous sacrament so that, bathed in the sweetness of your grace, we may pass over to the heavenly realities here foreshadowed. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song of adoration, and we, with all the hosts of angels, cry out and without end acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a new form, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Kevin, our Bishop and Arthur, our retired Bishop, and all your faithful people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Lord, we pray, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to you, apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever.
forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world.
Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word.
Thank you.
pray. In receiving this sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health of body and soul, as we confess your eternal Holy Trinity and undivided unity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for this mass.
Effective next weekend, the obligation to attend Mass on Sunday and Holy Days is reinstated. Monday is Memorial Day. Morning Mass will be at 9 a.m. The parish office will be closed. Enrollment for religious education, kindergarten through 8th grade, including confirmation, can now be submitted online. A payment portal is available also for all tuition and sacrament fees. Look for religious education on our website.
Now that the dispensation from attending Mass has been lifted, I welcome all of our parishioners who are in good health to celebrate the Eucharist in person, beginning next weekend on the Feast of the Body and Blood of Christ. Social distancing has been lifted, and masks are not required for those who are vaccinated. You'll notice as we get back to normal that holy water fonts and the baptismal font will have holy water. Altar servers will soon be returning to assist at the liturgical celebrations. Offertory processions will resume. Ushers will be taking up the collection at the normal time. Communion under both kinds will not resume at this time. The faithful are encouraged to receive communion in the hand, and those who wish to receive communion tongue may do so at the conclusion of the communion procession, as we have been doing. I would encourage you to use hand sanitizer before and after the distribution of Holy Communion. I'm delighted that we can once again celebrate the Eucharist in person, and I look forward to welcoming you back to church again beginning next weekend. We continue to pray for all those affected by the coronavirus, and we look forward to a time when they can join us too at the Lord's table. And now we stand for the final blessing. The Lord be with you, and may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thank you. Yeah. Have a very pleasant day today.
Thank you.